Being Navajo? Oh. Well, it means that I'm going to be a good person and work hard at my art. That's what it means to me. So.
I've always heard the term Navajo, but I think I like the word Diné better.
For me, it means really understanding who I am, and I guess in a really kind of informal way, understand that there's more to being an Indian than just going to powwows and stuff.
Being Navajo means we are unique.
I feel like unique because I'm the only Hopi and Tewa Pueblo here, and I'm representing my tribe.
And I like the I want to see a lot of the world too. I suppose that means that to me too. I remember when I was young, I always thought about New York. I guess some of the early things I remember about New York were things like I saw in the movies and whatnot. Like maybe there was a movie, The Warriors, some time back, which was a little bit about New York. And I remember that. And my parents had a big atlas. You know, a big book like that, and you know, thick and wide. And I remember looking at the street maps of New York and trying to place all the names and things that I had saw in the movie on the map and find them there. So I guess I like looked at all the maps. And, you know, I looked at the map and could see all the streets and wondered what they were like.
Getting out of my home.
I wanted to get away from family, far away from family.
I had a lot of responsibilities in my home, and it just was so much on me. So I felt like getting away and being able to learn something new and getting to meet new people, getting into a new environment, that was exciting for me.
I guess just trying new things.
Meeting new people, making new friends.
Learning about other culture, about other languages.
And kind of being able to take my own direction with whatever I wanted to do.
Because I remember like driving like as how far east have I ever had been, and I would think about like things on the road. Like we would always go to Albuquerque, but then we would stop at Albuquerque and turn around and go back the other way. So to go beyond Albuquerque was like, okay, that's now the line that you have crossed.
No, I don't think so.
No resistance, no problem. Just drive all the way.
No, they're one of the people that pushed me into going out of state, going to a good school.
Maybe not from my peers, like in class, but some of my family was like, why are you leaving? You know, like, you know, why are you leaving? Well, mainly it was just my mom, but and my grandparents too. And
if any resistance, there was probably some from my family.
On my way to New York, I stopped off at my parents' house, and they were surprised to see me, and they said that they thought I was coming to live with them, but then that's not what I was doing. So, and they told me that I couldn't stay there. So, and I told them that, well, I wasn't planning to stay here. So then the next morning I packed up and left.
It makes me sad because my younger siblings are growing up and getting more more involved, and it hurts me not being there to help or to watch them grow.
It was my first time actually leaving to a bigger city by myself, and I was kind of afraid because I didn't know what to do at first.
When I got here, it's just like I had a really hard time adjusting at first, and it was like freshman year was hard. Like
I had to really dig within me to speak more, because that was something that I struggled with, was not being able to say what I needed, and I guess being shy. Most Native American kids are shy. Yes, in fact, when I got to Fort Lewis College, they had a Native American club already on campus, and a place where the students who were Native American, and there were tribes from all over the place that came to that school, and they had a place to go and study, and they had someone there to assist us if we had questions and all that. So it was really nice for me to be able to go into a school and feel some connection somewhere.
I really didn't consider it a Native community at first, but once I got here, I'm really glad there was a strong Native community here, because to me, I feel like I wouldn't have survived here. I probably would have transferred long ago.
Well, once I found out that Dartmouth had a really big Native program, I was like, yes. Because like I could finally feel comfortable like being around people and just relaxing and not having to worry about stuff too much. I mean, not that I couldn't do that in high school, but I mean, like, when I look for a school, it's just like I was hoping there'd be like a lot more support.
I knew there were some Natives at New Mexico State University, but they were mixed, and I was interested in their tribe too.